What's up guys, Sal here. So it's been a while we haven't talked about the Galaxy Z Fold 3, Samsung's best offering in a handheld device. The Galaxy Z Fold has taken up the role of Samsung's futuristic test platform from the Galaxy Note lineup by offering bold new hardware that used to be the calling card of the Note. As you know already, Samsung is replacing the Note lineup with its foldable phones, so in order for them to fill that huge gap left by the absence of the Note, they need to make sure the Z Fold lineup gets more recognition both by the media and the people alike. And what better way to introduce a piece of tech that has never been seen on any of Samsung's phones? Time and again, we saw reports that the Galaxy Z Fold 3 will be the first Samsung phone to have an under-display camera. Later, we heard Samsung is experiencing some quality issues with this camera, and it's possible they might instead go for a pop-up mechanism for the front camera. But it looks like we might still get the under-display camera with the Z Fold 3. Our friendly neighborhood, Ice Universe, tweeted that the Z Fold 3 is still very likely to adopt under-panel camera. Samsung has been working on this tech since 2018 when the company discusses progress in an event. If you don't know, Samsung has already introduced under-panel camera tech for laptops. The main problem with these cameras is the photo quality and the lack of light exposure on the camera sensor. So AI computational photography will be needed to ensure the best results. But if Samsung is ready to use this tech in laptops, then they could be ready for smartphones as well. With that said, we've been seeing hints of S Pen support on the Z Fold 3 for quite some time now. While most of us naturally assume that that entails a stylus that slides inside the body of the phone, but now that Samsung has set a precedent with the S21 Ultra and it's entirely separate and optional, I've started wondering if perhaps Samsung will go that route instead with the Z Fold 3. By the way, there's no evidence for this, but considering their approach with the S Pen lately, it's totally possible we may not get a dedicated slot for the S Pen on the Z Fold 3, especially considering the space constraints inside the foldable phones. Anyway, to make sure the S Pen doesn't damage the display, they're using a thicker ultra-thin glass that's twice as thick as the one we have on the Z Fold 2. Also, the Z Fold 3 will launch with One UI 3.5. This implies that the devices will probably launch in the second half of this year. Samsung has just released the One UI 3.1 with the Galaxy S21 series, so it will take some time before the company start working on a new version, even if it's just an iterative update. Ice Universe says we have to wait for at least 5 months to see the Z Fold 3 and the Z Flip, which is in line with what we've been hearing that Samsung is planning to launch the handsets in July. Also, S-Connect, who makes hinges for these foldable phones for Samsung, has confirmed that they will launch the Galaxy Tab S8 and S8 Plus alongside the Z Fold 3 and Z Flip 3. They said they are producing double the amount of hinges as they produced last year and expect the foldable smartphone market to reach 5.5 million sold units this year. Interestingly, they mentioned nothing about the Galaxy Z Fold Lite. Of course, with that being said, do let me know what you think about this down in the comments. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.